Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of Power BI tutorial. So today we are going to discuss matrix visualization in the Power BI. So this is very important visualization in the Power BI by which we can see the detailed information as well as the summarized information in the same page. So how we can use this? Let's go to on the Power BI desktop and we'll see in the practical. So this is our project by which currently we are working on. So first of all, let me use the matrix. So we can click on this and let me try to make it bigger. So here, as we have already created the hierarchies, so I'm going to delete that one and try to create the new one. So that will be helpful for you guys. So I have created two hierarchies. So let me delete the second one as well. And here now we don't have any hierarchy. So first we want to create the hierarchy for country name, then city, then postal code. So we need to drag and drop the city to the country name. So it will create the hierarchy. So here you can see the country name and city. Next, we want to drag and drop the postal code. So postal code can be dropped in this hierarchy which we have created. So now you can see country name, city and postal code which we have created. Now let me try to drag and drop in the rows. So here we can see we are having Australia. If we'll expand that, then we'll see all these cities which belongs to the Australia. And if we'll expand, then we'll see the postal code for that. So this is the rows data. Now in the columns, we want to see the data as per the order date. So we can drag and drop the order date right here. So here it by default has the hierarchy for the year, quarter, month and day. So that is fine. And in the values, let me try to drag and drop the order quantity. And it should be sum. So it is already sum. So that is good. Now you can see we are having this matrix. Let me try to little bit format this. So go to on the format and here go to on the style. We can choose any style which we want. So this might be good. Now go to on the grid and try to make the font size bigger. So we can do that. So this is the font size. That is enough, I guess. So now here you can see we are having all the countries. So let me try to expand that. So here you can see the cities. If we'll expand, then we can see the postal code. Here the order quantities for the cities and postal code and country that is displaying over here. So this is how we can drill down from the rows. Here we can see in the columns it is displaying the year, but we wanna drill down up to day. So how we can do that? So first of all, we have to select that visualization, that is matrix. Here you can see drill on. So here we need to select the columns. Now we need to select this drill down option. Now here we can press the control and click on this. So it will have the data for quarter 2, quarter 3 and quarter 4. Now let me click on the quarter 3. So it will have the months, like July, August and September. Let me try to click on the July. So this time we'll have all the days. So we can see 1, 2, 3 up to 31st. So this is that we can drill down from columns as well. So go to on the first level. So this is the first level. Now if we don't want to see the quarterly data, we just want to see the data for month and year. So how we can do that? So for that, go to on the fields and here in the hierarchy we can delete anything. Like we don't want to see the data for the quarter, so we can delete the quarter. Now here we can see the days, so we don't want to see the data for days, so we can also delete that. Now let me try one more time. So here we have this year and here we can see all these months. If we click any month, then it will not further drill down. Next, here it has only order quantity. If we want to see the data for other quantity with the values, so how we can do that? Here, let me try to drag and drop the second. That will be the, I guess, subtotal. So let me try to drag and drop in the values. So here it will have two columns. First is the order quantity and second will have the subtotal. We can add n number of columns as per our requirement. So here I am very happy to use only these two columns. So here we have years. Now let me click on this. So here months, and again it is having two columns for the order quantity and subtotals. So this is in the matrix, and if you have any doubt, then you can drop your question in the comment box. So I will try to answer on your questions. So thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.